Welcome back to The Ed Show, and thanks for watching tonight. We hit a devastating milestone today. It's day 100 of the effort to restore the Gulf Coast after the disaster at the Deepwater Horizon rig that claimed the lives of 11 workers. Now the federal government is launching a major criminal investigation into BP, Transocean, and Halliburton to determine if the companies lied to regulators or doctored safety tests. The so-called BP squad is being run out of the FBI and could lead to prison time for executives if the feds prove their case. For more, let's bring in environmental lawyer Mike Papantonio. His firm is leading the class action lawsuits against BP. Mike, what does this mean if they're cooking the safety books, and what does it mean to your RICO case that you're involved in?
I think what's happening is they see now that there's more than just negligence involved here. Look, this is a group of very capable attorneys, FBI agents, some of the best investigators in the country that are kicking over this rotten log. And what's coming out is some of the same story I'm seeing on the civil side. We're seeing relationships between government and the petroleum industry where there's something that's nothing less than bribery. There's no way you can qualify it other than anything than bribery. It's phonied up documents. It's phonied up tests where they actually take test results and they change the results, or they don't do tests they know they're supposed to do, tests they're supposed to mandate. We see obstruction of justice. Look, I got to tell you something, Ed. I was a prosecutor before I moved into this area of the law, and I know what a criminal offense looks like. They're going to be prosecuted. It's just a matter of who. Now, here's what's happening. You have whistleblowers who are out there right now who are afraid to come forward. And what they need to be watching is their friends that are pleading the Fifth Amendment, people that are taking the stand and saying, I can't testify because I'm afraid I might be criminally prosecuted. What a whistleblower who has information about right now better understand, you do not run from the FBI. You don't hide from the FBI because you'll end up on the wrong side of the bars with the FBI. The best advice I can tell these people that are afraid to come forward, they're protecting a supervisor, they're protecting their career, they're protecting their company, is when you have the FBI and you have the best lawyers in this country with the Justice Department. Let me just tell you something. These are not political hacks. These are some of the most talented trial lawyers in this country. And when you have them coming after you, you better pay attention and you better be afraid to take the company line. That's the best advice I can give to people who might be listening to this show, who might be hiding information.
Well, it sounds like the Justice Department is using the full force of resources to go after these folks. Are you confident that they'll get everything uncovered? And are you confident that there's going to be prosecutions?
Right now, Ed, there's such a blueprint that has been created by private attorneys, by some of the attorneys I work with along the coast, that we've been working on this for 100 days. And I'm not just talking about just the day and night for 100 days.
Your prediction is that they will not escape this.
They will not. I got to tell you something. If we just had the playbook that we have as civil lawyers on the table right now, somebody is going to go to prison. And right now, it's like musical chairs. The person out there who believes that they can get away with this and is not going to say anything because they're afraid to, they might be the last one standing in a case of musical chairs, and they need to be very, very careful.
So BP and these oil companies, in the past, they've been able to dodge the bullet, skip out with a lesser fee, but they're not going to do it this time. You're confident of that?
I'm confident, Ed. They've had political coverage in the past. We had 8 years of Republicans that gave this petroleum industry coverage at every turn. Obama is not going to give these people political coverage. If he does, it's going to be very evident to the American public, and it's going to cost him dearly in the next election. You have a coast that understands day-to-day what's happening down here. They're not naive. If this is a whitewash investigation, it will cost Obama dearly.
Mike Papantonio, always a pleasure. Great to have you on, buddy. Thanks so much for your time again
tonight.
Thank you,
Ed.